What's up, guys? It is Bernardo from the BTNHD, and today is all about deploying a Wi-Fi profile on Windows 10 using SCCM. So let's get started. So the first things first, for this to work correctly, you need a laptop or a machine that has Wi-Fi to connect to your Wi-Fi at your 9-to-5 job, because we need to export a profile. So I'm going to right click on the start menu, click on run, and I'm going to type in WinVer and hit OK. And I'm running everything within a Windows 10 build 19577. Now the build doesn't really matter, but I like to show you guys what I'm running within my lab. Right click on the start menu, pick Windows PowerShell, make sure you run it as an admin, and the following command we need to run onto our PowerShell. Now this command right here, netsh wlan show profiles, when you hit enter, it's gonna give you a nice little list of all the profiles or all the Wi-Fi access points that your machine has, logged into. So what I'm gonna do is on the desktop, I'm gonna right click, go to new, create a new folder. I'm gonna name it Wi-Fi profile, double click on it. I'm gonna highlight that link because I need that link. I'm gonna right click on it and I'm going to copy. Now I'm gonna go back inside PowerShell. I'm gonna run the following command, netsh wlan export profile name equals, open and close quotations, inside those quotations, the name of your profile. For me, it was BTNHD, and the reason why I know that, I ran the show profile commandlet to get that name. Folder equals and the path of where you want to drop your profile. So again, I copied and pasted it right in there, and then you also want to enter the parameter of key equals clear. Once you hit enter, boom, the profile will be exported to a specific folder that you provided, and you're done. If you double click on that Wi-Fi profile folder, which I created, or whatever you created, you're going to see an XML file. If you right click on it and you edit within your favorite notepad, or I like to use notepad++, so I'm going to open it up and you're going to see all this nice little gibberish. Now you probably see a couple of blurry stuff, is because one, it gives you a lot of important information that you don't want to share out. So we need to get into our SCCM server. That's the next step. Now I didn't know how to do this, so I dropped my XML file on the desktop. And the reason why I said to you guys, I didn't know how to do this, because this is my first time actually importing a Wi-Fi profile within SCCM. I received an error during this process, and I'm gonna show you guys how I fix it. So we're gonna open up your SCCM console. We need to get into assets and compliance. And within there, go inside compliance settings and locate company resource access. And you're going to see Wi-Fi profile. So select it. We're going to right click on that and do a create Wi-Fi profile. You're going to get this nice create Wi-Fi profile wizard. We're going to give it a name. Make sure you check that little mark that says import an existing Wi-Fi profile item from a file, because we already have a file. That's what we want. And hit next. And then from here, click on add. From here, I went to my desktop and I selected my XML, hit open, and I received an error. Apparently, your XML file has to be located within a network path. So I dropped it inside a network path. I have a folder within my SCCM server called sources, which contains my OSD files, my packages, and et cetera, et cetera. So within sources, I created a folder called Wi-Fi profile. So I could just drop any profile in here for future reference, right? So I drop my XML file that we created together. I paste that USC path inside, hit open, and boom, success. Click next. From here, you gotta pick your platform. I kinda want only Windows 10, 64, 32-bit. You are able to pick whatever you want within your environment, whatever fits for you. For me, for this example, I'm only going to pick Windows 10, 64, and 32-bit. Hit next. Get a nice little confirmation of the settings that you made. Click next, it's gonna start doing its thing. And then boom, green check marks, which is always a good thing. And we're gonna close it. Now you got your profile. So the next thing that we need to do is right click on your profile and hit deploy. Now from here, we need to hit browse to pick your collection. I didn't pick my collection because most likely within my lab, I don't have any machines that need this Wi-Fi profile, but for you, most likely you have a user collection. For example, let's say you have consultants that have laptops, right? And you wanna pick that collection. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to hit that like button. Also comment below if you're doing this within your environment. Also hit that subscribe button, punch it, elbow it, smash it, do whatever you need to do. And I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.